If it wasn't for welders, we would be living in the Stone Age. Literally. The buildings, you know, the infrastructure of the world we live in is all here because of the welding technology.
When the industry tells us what their needs are and we're training people to do this, then we're giving the industry what they need. What we generally do is we teach an oxy-fuel welding, then we teach both types of stick welding. There's two different kinds of rods, same process, but different rods that we use. And then we go into a wire feed, and then we do the TIG welding. And one of the things that we have found is we kind of let the people where they find what they like best and what they work best on is usually the direction they go in. That may be aerospace, maybe working down the shipyard, maybe working in structural stuff, maybe construction in the field.
The environment here is great. Everyone has all the time that they need to practice on improving their skills. We're not only learning how to weld, just the practical part, you start understanding electricity and polarity and magnetism and all this information that you never thought about.
So as far as our graduates go, they're going into a lot of different industries. I can't say that there's any one industry that they go into, because we have students that go into aerospace and they're welding stuff that's like, you know, almost microscopic.
We have connections with all of the industry in all of those areas, so we put them there. And then we have a lot of entry-level jobs, even where guys will start out kind of sweeping the floor and then work into a few other things.
I like it when the light comes on. Of course, every teacher says that, you know, when it clicks for people. But what really motivates me is when students come back and say, hey, I got this job, I'm making this much, thank you so much for, you know, helping me get to where I'm at.
I didn't realize that I was going to get so into working with metal, and it's so cool.
I really like welding.